Magandang umaga, Pilipinas! Welcome to Agri TV's Bad About Koy. My name is Mike Hernandez and...
Glessie Hernandez of Koy's and Ponds Farm, Las Piñas.
So, today, pag-uusapan po natin ang pangatlong series ng pinangako po namin sa inyo. Paano po natin gagawin to? In the first two episodes, sinabi po natin yung ingress. And then later on, ano po yung ginagawa natin during the show proper itself. Mm-hmm. Today, eto, tapos na po yung show. Ano po yung mga pointers na dapat natin gawin?
You have to make sure that, you know, this hobbyist will bag their koi. But sometimes, laging nangyayari, kulang yung plastic bags nila. And you have to have an oxygen on standby all the time until everybody leaves, no? And you have to have enough rubber bands to wrap them with. So, some boxes also, they might find it necessary.
Mag-ingat lang po tayo kung kayo ay nag-handle ng koi sa tinulungan natin. Yung koi sa koi tub number 1, and then you will help the owner dun sa koi tub number 2. You need to disinfect again your hands and rinse it, and then go to the next tub na tutulungan natin.
So, hindi lang your hands, pati yung net, in case you use a net. If you look at the video, how na si Tom, he uses his own hands to catch the koi. Because you could use the net, but of course, disinfect, but it, since marami sabay-sabay, mm-hmm. if you're able to use your hands and put it in the bag mm-hmm. right away, that would be even more convenient for everybody and safer.
One thing to consider, pag gumamit kayo ng plastic bag, it has to be pahaba, elongated. No? Like mention natin kanina, kung maaari, if the koi is 20 centimeters, the bag should be at least 20 centimeters bigger. Pag binag natin, dapat nakahiga yan. And then kung maaari, ito ay triple yung bag. Especially kung ita-transport nyo uli out of Metro Manila kung isasakay nyo on board sa plane.
Yes, saka make sure that the water reaches the gills. Full yung coverage yung gills ng water. And then if it's not, ano naman, it's not going to be transported by air, you could be generous with the water, until you cover the dorsal fin.
Why do we say that? Because pagka mababa yung water, syempre mas mura yung transport fee
yes.
sa airline, because in as much as we would like to save on a transport fee, siguro naman mas mahal yung koi na i-move natin. So if there's a little difference of higher water para sa safety ng koi, ibigay nyo na po yun, yung tubig na yun.
Saka yung paglagay sa kotse, make sure yung placement ng box ng koi, ito yung kotse, naka-horizontal na gano'n, positioning.
If the box is naka-parallel sa kotse, na pag-mount ninyo, there's a higher chance of masugatan yung bibig or mabali po yung buntot. Pa-quarantine po natin yung koi for 21 days. Best health practice is 21 days. One good practice na ginagawa po sa America in after a koi show, in the most part in the States, they do this. They identify the fish after the hobbies, identify their respective fish kung saan nila ibabag.
Mm-hmm.
So once na-identify na po nila yung isda, then the chairman, the show chairman, starts to announce, pwede na po ninyong ibag yung mga isda ninyo. And then walang confusion. Hanggang sa last minute, we are still careful of the fish health. Thank you friends for joining us today. Maraming salamat po sa lahat ng nag-participate dun sa 30th anniversary koi show ng Koi's and Ponds. It was a successful one. And then sana po may na-share kami sa inyo ngayong in-impart namin itong tatlong episodes ng how to mount a more enjoyable and safe koi show.
Mm-hmm.
So join us again next week. Babalik po tayo sa States at papakita po natin what do we have here, Glessie.
Ruel Abreu's newly renovated pond and also how his koi are doing. They look really excellent.
So join us again next week. My name is Mike Hernandez.
And Glessie Hernandez.
Ito lang po yan sa AgriTV at iba pa. Mad About Koi, Kita Kids. See you next week.
Bye!
Bye-bye.